Hi there, this is Kelly Wilder, one of your librarians here at St. Philip's College Library. And today, in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about one of my favorite databases. I'm really not sure if I'm allowed to say that, but here we are. And that is the database Academic Search Complete. And the reason I love Academic Search Complete so much is because it's one of those huge general databases. It houses tons of academic journals, magazines, for pretty much any topic you can imagine. And so it's a really good starting point for your research, and a lot of times you can get all of your research done for a particular project right here. So let's get started. From the library homepage, right here where we are, you get to Academic Search Complete by going into the library databases. So if you see right here where it says Library Resources, the second one down, Library Databases, we'll click there. And again, the second one down, Academic Search Complete is right here. So we're going to click on that. Now, if you're not on campus like I am, it would ask you to log in, and the screen that pops up that tells you to log in is going to say that your username is your ACES ID and your password is your banner ID, and those two things should get you right into this database where I am right now. If that does not work for you, please contact us in the library. We can get you added in, back in really quickly, but we don't know unless you tell us, so please let us know if you're having any difficulty at all accessing these databases. So, you get here to Academic Search Complete. It might look a little intimidating because there's so much available on here, but it's actually pretty simple once you get to it. I will tell you the very first thing I do when I'm working on a project and I'm using Academic Search Complete is I click where it says full text. And the reason for that is that this database is so big and so robust that it will tell you something exists even if you don't have access to it. And that is fantastic if you're working on your doctoral dissertation. And it's just very frustrating if you're working on an English paper where you need three or four sources. So if you tell it you only want full text, it will only give you results that we have full text access to. So click the full text. Next down here it says scholarly peer-reviewed journals. You can also narrow your search to only scholarly journals, and that's something you might do depending on the level of research you're doing, or of course if your instructor has said, I will only accept scholarly sources, click here and that will limit your results to only those things that are scholarly. Right over here, you can also limit by dates. So if your instructor says nothing more than 5 years old, you can put in a 5-year date range here and you'll only get results from that range. So let's talk a little bit about searching Academic Search Complete. So like I said, you can search just about anything that you can imagine here. So let's think of a quick topic because we don't have all day for me to consider that. Let's do oceanography. And you'll notice as I start typing in ocean, you start seeing things like ocean, ocean pollution, acidification, pollution effects. So you start seeing all of these different things, and that can be really helpful because it might be that your particular topic that you're interested in is right here. For now, I'm going to click on the one that says oceanography, because that's what I said. And then I'm going to click on search. So you'll see right here it says search results. I got 21,698 full text results. That's a lot. So I would highly recommend not sorting through this many results. It's too time consuming and most of us have way too much to do. So if you look down this left side here, you'll see that there are all sorts of ways that you can refine your results. This is a great thing. Make it your friend. The first thing I notice is right here where it says publication date. I have articles here between 1941 all the way to 2019. Now, 1941 for scientific research is getting a little old, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to change that to 2014. Oops. So I'm going to change that to 2014. Oops. Try again. There we go. I'm going to change it to 2014, and now it's going to limit my results to just the past 5 years, and that's already knocked us down to 7,886. Still way too many, but we're getting somewhere. You'll also notice here where it says source types, I can narrow down again to academic journals, which are scholarly sources, magazines, book reviews, newspapers, and the like. So let's pretend my instructor said only academic journals, and I can see right here that that's going to narrow my results to 7,561. So we're getting closer and closer to what I want. And then the next, one of the most important things is you'll see here where it says subject, the thesaurus term and subject term. This will narrow you down to what these articles are about, which is getting you closer and closer and closer to finding exactly what you want. So let's say I'm specifically into ocean circulation. And I click on that. Now I'm down to 453 results, like it says right here. And I can keep doing this over and over again until I get down to something that works for me. So now I see climate change. So I'm interested in climate change along with these topics. And what I've done now is I've limited my results to only full text items that are from academic journals published between 2014 and now that talks also, in addition about oceanography, about ocean circulation and climate change. So all of those things have to be in the article for me to get the result, which has narrowed me down to 30, which is a much more manageable number. Now, should I at any point decide that I've gone too far with this, I can click on the X next to any one of these limiters and it will back me out of that one in particular and I can start over. So it's a good way to kind of keep most of your search terms without losing, you know, and just lose the ones that are not helpful to you. So we're looking through here, we've got this wonderful list. These are the titles that are hyperlinked here. And let's say I'm interested in this fourth one on the dynamics of water mass transformation of a boundary current connecting alpha and beta oceans. Sounds interesting, so let's click on it. And what pops up next is some very important things here. This is not the full text of the article yet, right here. You'll have the subject terms that were used to describe this particular article. This is particularly helpful if you are in the position where you worked really hard to find even one thing that was useful to you. You might try looking at the subject terms to see if maybe there's a better term than what you were using to narrow your search down and search again later. The other thing is this abstract. Abstract is just our fancy academic word for a summary. So when you read this abstract, it will give you an idea of what's covered in the article so you don't waste your precious time with articles that aren't covering what you're looking for. This particular one is only 19 pages, as you see, but it's 19 pages of academic writing, so you can expect you to take more than an hour to read it. So by reading that abstract first, you can find out whether or not it's going to be helpful to you. This particular article has both HTML and PDF full text. So since there's an HTML full text, you can just scroll down and see this article right here, the full text of it. A very cool thing with the ones that has HTML full text is that you can tell it what accent you want and you can listen to it instead of read it if that is more comfortable for you. So keep that in mind. Another wonderful tool with our HTML ones are you can translate it too. So I can come over here to choose language. And if I read more comfortably in a language that's not English, I can translate this article to that language, which I think is very helpful for our students. So keep that in mind. And then my suggestion to you when you're doing research is not to find one article and then read it, you know, open up the PDF, read the whole thing, and then find another article. Your brain will be happier to you while you're doing research if you gather your information in one setting and then at another time sit down and read and synthesize that information. So what I would suggest is that after you've read the abstract, if it looks like this is an article you can use, come over here to the right. Remember, everything on here is something you can use. And you'll see where it says email. If you click on the email icon here, you put in your own email address, and it can be any email. It can be your Gmail or your Hotmail or ACES email, whatever you actually use. Put that in there. And then come over here where it says citation format, and tell it what citation you need for your class. So if your instructor said use MLA, use MLA. If they said use APA, use APA. Do as your instructor said on that. And then when you hit send, what it's going to do is it's going to send you an email that has the PDF full text as a separate attachment and the HTML full text if it's available, and also a proper citation for you right there in the email so you've kept all of your information together. So that's a little bit about using Academic Search Complete. I hope it's been helpful to you, and best of luck going forward. As always, if you need more help, just let us know, and we'll be right there for you in the library. Thanks.